Good morning, students. Today we will do the question answers in detail of lesson 3. Now, starting with the first question, differentiate between the herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Now, after reading the chapter and doing the keywords and short question answers, I think you all might be very fluent with these three terms: herbivores, carnivores, and omnivores. Now, herbivores, what are they? Yes, they are the animals that eat only plants, grass, fruits, and vegetables. So these are the main points: plants, grass, fruits, and vegetables. An example: cow, deer. We have mentioned too. You know that horse, buffalo, rest also. There are many herbivores. So this is the definition of a herbivore. Carnivore is an animal that eats flesh of other animals. So, eating flesh of other animal is the main highlighting point of a carnivore. An example: lion, tiger. And the third, omnivores, animals that eat flesh of other animals and plants both. So, an omnivore is eating what? Flesh also and plants also. And the examples are bear, crow. So, bear eats grass also, or bamboo sticks also, and eats fish also. And apart from bear, crow, we know that even human beings are omnivores. So I suppose now the differentiation between these three terms is quite clear. Now the next question is, distinguish between chewing the cud and tearing the food. Chewing the cud. Now this is an important technique which is undertaken or a part of the method of feeding and digestion of herbivores. Now what happens is, in case of herbivores, this method is present. What do the herbivores like cow, deer, buffalo, they do is, herbivores like cow, deer, buffalo, and sheep first chew their food a little and then swallow it. So you can see the underlined areas: first chew a little and then swallow. So they just start pluck the food, chew it for a little time and then swallow it, like that only. Then the second point is, after some time they bring it back in their mouth and chew it for hours. So it means that after swallowing, then they take some time, they sit somewhere or stand leisurely and then bring back the food from their stomach back into their mouth and then again start chewing it, and now they take a number of hours in doing this process. So they slowly keep on chewing the food brought back from their stomach into their mouth. So herbivores, what do? First chew the food a little and then swallow it in the first step. In the second step, they bring back that swallowed food from their stomach into their mouth and then keep on chewing it for hours. Now the second part of the question is tearing the food. Now tearing the food is a process that is generally adopted by carnivores. Now carnivores eat their food like this. Carnivores like tiger, lion, and wolf tear the flesh of other animals. This is the first step. And how do they tear? We very well know they have sharp pointed teeth, front teeth, which are generally known as canines, with the help of which they can tear apart the flesh of the animal which they are eating or which they have hunted. In the second step, what they do is they chew the food properly with strong jaws and do not bring the food back in their mouth. So what do? They chew the food properly with the help of strong jaws. Now see, they have to tear the flesh and chew that flesh. So they have very strong teeth also, and along with very strong jaws, which help them to chew their food properly. And the one thing which is makes them different from the herbivores are that they do not bring the food back into their mouth. Once chewed and then gulped, it goes back into the stomach. It does not come back into the mouth, as in case of herbivores. So tearing the food present in case of carnivores, and what do? They tear the flesh of other animals and then after tearing the flesh, they chew the food properly with their strong jaws, and but do not bring that food back into their mouths. So we can easily now differentiate between chewing of cud and tearing the food. The next question is, what kind of eating habits do leech and earthworms have? Now, both leech and earthworms, they both have a different kind of feeding habits. If we talk first about the earthworms, what we read is, they swallow the soil to eat remains of dead plants and animals in it. So, this is the eating method of earthworms. What do? They swallow the soil. And what is in the soil? The remains of dead plants and animals and vegetation, dirt, whatever is there, they are able to swallow it. And it happens because they have a very hard and pointing mouth, with the help of which they can swallow and even burrow into the soil and swallow the soil containing all these remains of dead plants and animals. And then it passes on into its small intestines, and ultimately it is converted into nutrients which is passed into the earth. On the other hand, leeches, they are having a different way. They have circular mouth with toothed jaws by which they stick to the body of the animals and suck the blood. So leeches, the main feeding method is to suck the blood. And how are they able to do that? To suck the blood, they have to stick to the body of the animal. And how do they stick? With the help of the toothed jaws that are present in its circular mouth. So the toothed jaws help this leech to stick to the body of the animal and suck its blood, and hence feed itself. So these are the two different methods of or habits of eating of leech and earthworm. Now the last question is, define food chain with the help of an example. We have very well, I think, understood what a food chain is. The chain formed when plants are eaten by animals, and then these animals are further eaten up by other animals. So the chain is starting from where? The plants. The plants are at the lowest level because they are the producers, and they are being consumed by different consumers at different levels. Plants being the main at the lowest level, they are eaten up by animals. And which animals eat plants? A herbivore animal. And a herbivore animal is then further eaten up by another animal, which is obviously a carnivorous animal. So this is what forms a food chain. Now example first is grass, which is eaten up by grasshopper. Grasshopper is further eaten up by frog, and frog is eaten up ultimately by the snake. In the second example, plant is eaten up by deer, which is a herbivore and is the primary consumer, and this deer is eaten up by a lion, which is a carnivorous and is the ultimate consumer. So these are the two examples of a food chain. I hope you all have understood the question and answers properly. Thank you.